lost all ambition or worldly. All right. Hello, everybody. Welcome to another night of streaming. And today is a very special night because I get to be here tonight with you, hanging out, playing some games and talking some shit. So welcome in everybody who is coming already to hang out on the stream. Tonight, we are going to be playing some Half-Life from 1998. So technically a retro game, guys. I'm still a fucking retro streamer. And NaviNix is in the chat with the hype, dropping some Mikey emotes and some hearts, some love. NaviNix is probably, she'll fight if someone, you know, if I don't say this, but NaviNix is the biggest fan of the stream, and she will fight anybody who will say anything different. So, guys, drop some love for NaviNix. She herself also streams, so if you don't follow her, you know, if you see this video a little later or whatever, you know, look her up. NaviNix is the goat Anix. But tonight, guys, we're going to be playing some Half-Life. We're going to be going back to the game that started it all, that started the streams, that started the hype, the love, and all that. And we're going to be, you know, doing it with you guys for as long as I can. I wanted to actually stream earlier today. I wanted to stream about maybe like 6 hours earlier. And I was going to hop on around 10. NaviNix said, thank you, Mikey. Of course. I got to recognize, you know, you probably donated the most. You've probably come to the most streams. You've probably chatted the most. And you've probably hyped and shared my stream more than anybody. So, I mean, it's fair to say that you probably are the biggest fan of the stream. As of now, you know, you never know, some random could come and take your place. But, you know, just kidding. I'm just kidding. That'll never happen, Navi. Nobody can ever take your place. But guys, we're going to be going ahead and starting Half-Life. We got some stuff to talk about tonight. I had a little bit of some deep thoughts last night while I was just, you know, hanging out, having a little insomnia and not necessarily getting some much needed sleep. But, you know, we're out here and we're doing what we need to do to live life, I guess. So a thought I had last night. Just while we're here, and real quick, I'll read NaviNix's chat. She said, NaviNix said, I'll fight for that title. Haha, I know you will. I know you will. I know if you see somebody donate like 100 subs, you'll donate 200. So hopefully that never happens because I don't need you doing all that. You'll go broke. But regardless, so last night I had this thought because me and my friend were talking about the Bible. You know, we were watching this family. NaviNix said, bet. But I mean, I'm just saying, you know, hopefully you retain your title forever. But me and my friend were watching Family Guy, and he asked me a question about, you know, how accurate the Family Guy episode was being on the depiction of the birth of Christ, because they were doing like a Christmas episode. And because I went to Catholic school, he asked me, you know, like how accurate I guess it is. And I told him, like, I mean, I guess that's like the basis of the story. It's pretty accurate. Like, it gets like the rundown points. If you're just like, yeah, there was a lady, she got knocked up by God and she was a virgin. It was just like a spirit. But he asked me why, or I don't know if he asked me why, but I don't think he asked me why. But I remember kind of emphasizing the point to him on why it was important that the Son of God, or just kind of how the fact that it was contradictory that the Son of the most valuable or important being in our existence or universe, depending on whatever your beliefs is. But right now we're talking about like Judeo-Christian, I guess Islamic God, because they all believe in the God of Abraham. But, you know, they're talking about this Messiah, sorry, I couldn't think of the word for a sec, being born out of a manger, and how back then, now we think it's like, oh, Jesus was born in a farm, cute, you know, there was hay and there was a donkey and you know, the star and the angel were there and like but, and sorry guys, we'll get to the gameplay real quick, but you know, we think about a very commercialized version of how impactful it was that the most important person, the most important being of our salvation or whatever as humans, as our purpose in life, half-life, just kidding, was born out of being around filth, around animals, how animals back then were seen as just filthy, how people really had, just try to put yourself in a place where your people had this really hardcore mentality of judgment, where if you were born out of dirt, you were treated less than dirt. It's kind of crazy. So the fact that the Son of God was born out of this manger, out of this farm where there's, you know, to put it in, you know, crude terms, donkey shit and, you know, animal crap and just, you know, all this stuff that comes around with being animal. Because, you know, animals are not necessarily clean. I mean, they go in the water or whatever, but they're not necessarily soaping themselves. They're not like humans, right? And back then, there was less attention put into sanitation and things like that. So just try to put yourself into the impactfulness of that, right? So I emphasize that to him because what I thought about now is that there is no belief. There is a modern and a new wave of nihilism, and it's a sort of modern nihilism where people are not necessarily saying that nothing not matters, but there's still a fatigue and a hard to continue, a hard to just move forward. Oh, whoa, I see some hype in the chat. Sally's coming in with the hype emotes. Yeah, look at that, dropping some Mikey emotes, some Retro Realm emotes, and oh my god, real quick, while we're here, thanks to Sully, got a good reminder, thanks to those emotes. Guys, we are Retro Realmers, we are part of the Retro Realm. The Retro Realm is one of the best communities in Discord. If you're not part of the Retro Realm, go ahead and join it. You can type !Discord, and it'll pop out a link for you to join that bitch and be part of one of the best communities, if not the best community in Discord, one of the most supportive. You are a streamer or just somebody who is looking to discuss retro games, retro technologies, retro movies, retro show, retro music, whatever you like to talk about. It doesn't matter whether it's from the 90s, the 80s, the 70s. We talk about everything. We are here to help you out in everything and just have a good time hanging out on this awesome realm that we call the internet and the retro realm. So guys, be sure to join that. Flop Flop, wake up. Gordon, wake up and smell the ashes. Whoa, Flop Flop. Flop Flop. How are you, Flop Flop? This is not a first time chat, so you've been here before, but welcome. We're going to be starting our new game. I've been locked away in the boss's dungeon. Oh, is that true? But welcome in, guys. If you are new, if you're chilling, we're playing some Half-Life from 1998 while we're talking some deep, deep topics tonight. I really stopped to think and what happened to mankind putting emphasis and love and effort into just every little life, the possibly. Oh shit, shit, oh shit, shit. Shit, 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 shit. Ivan, my boy, Ivan, Cabin Trip Ivan? Sleepy Jackson Ivan? That Ivan? OG Bree is in the house, OG Bree. I heard OG Bree's been doing some tournaments. OG Bree has been doing some tournaments on the Tetris. Showing her stuff to the world. Kicking ass, I'm hoping. Representing the good people of the Retro Realm. And Navinix, thanks for giving out all those shoutouts to people. Welcome in to everyone who's just tuning in right now. But flip flop, OG Bree said no, playing comp. I don't know what the fuck that means. I'm confused now. Do I get to shoot down that bitch? I'm not gonna take my chances with no goddamn helicopter. I know maybe here we get a rocket launcher. Navinix said maybe the mode, not a tournament. Ah, okay. So she's just, I guess, playing competitively for fun, I guess. Sully, thank you for that shout out to Navinix. Also, is Navinix, can you give a shout out to Sully for also being an awesome mod? And I think Navi, OG Bree is a mod too. If not, I should perhaps mod her. I don't know how OG Bree will feel about being modded, though. I will ask her. But thank you for that shout out to Sully, Navinix. Navinix. Abokanix. Navi, one that told me, she said, hey, mate, I'm going to write Abokanix. She was like, I'm going to write a book. I was like, a book? And she was like, nah, mate, a book on X. She's not, but I highly back this vote. Okay, all right, yeah. Well, maybe. I mean, I don't know. Ojibri tends to be in her own world when she's watching the stream, so I don't know. I don't want to disrupt her gaming time on Tetris from, you know. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, what the fuck? What the fuck? I don't even know what happened. They got shot down by something. Ooh. But guys, how are we tonight? We're going to be discussing modern nihilism, the new wave, how it is affecting us today, and how we, as I think a generation, are just tired. You know, we miss the nostalgia. And we want to have that passion and that innocence back. But we just can't come to bring that life back to it. I don't know. I mean, or maybe that's just maybe me. Maybe I'm the fucking nihilist cynic. But I just think that people don't put emphasis in the beauty of everyday little things. That's my opinion. And, you know, we're going to be talking about that as we go on and as we keep drinking this whiskey. Zoinks. Now, I'm excited. If she no one to mod, I definitely vote OG VIP. I don't even know how to do the VIPs. Ah, same way. Use hashtag VIP. What the fuck? What the fuck? /VIP Ojibree, I think. Yeah, we'll do that. I mean, if she wants to be VIP, I don't know, man. Ojibree might not want to be VIP in this channel. She might want to be VIP in some Tetris channels, for all I know. I mean, I don't want to be forcing nothing into anyone. You know what I'm saying? Do I go down? Something happened when they blew up earlier. Now they said, I'll take VIP. You're more than VIP. You're a mod. You're a mod IP. VI mod. Modonix. I don't have anything. VIP is just a badge. I don't even have badges for people. Oh, what the fuck? God damn it. This game is so fucking hard, I swear to God. I don't know how Phil Schneider did this, guys. I really don't. It's a Twitch badge. I know it's a Twitch badge, but how the fuck in shit are they able to get me? Like how the sword is a mod. Oh, yeah. Okay, well, whoever wants to be a VIP... if you donate a sub, I'll make you the VIP. How about that? So I guess Navi and like Selly and a bunch of other people are probably VIP. Holy shit. This is tough. Because I don't know how to get out of this situation. I could be VIP over 50,000. Yeah, probably. You probably donated the most out of anyone. I think I have to go down there. Yeah, fuck that shit. I'm not gonna be dealing with that. I thought the helicopter exploded because of like aliens attacking it or something, but nope, it didn't do shit. So we're just gonna move on. Could I go down there? Maybe. I'm not gonna risk it. Well, I'm not gonna risk that either. This is that. Hold on. This is that spot. This is the spot where I fought those guys, and I thought that I couldn't come here. And look at that, guys! I'm here. I didn't know. Wow. Wowzers! Wow. I feel like Owen Wilson, guys. Oh, fuck. Hate those guys. Don't want anything to do with that. Hate when they jump at me when I'm in the vent. Wow. Wow. But guys, what do you think? You think there's a modern wave of nihilism? You think people are ignoring the everyday beauty of things? As, you know, we go through life. Wow. Let me turn off my light. I don't want them to see me. They're going to be like, what the fuck is that? Check the vents. Oh, I could make you. Or I could murk you, motherfuckers. I could murk you so bad. Oof. Ooh, that's scary. They didn't see me. Oh, fuck. Okay, we gotta keep going the other way, I guess. It's crazy how much John McClaning you have to do in this game. And if you don't know what John McClaning is, I recommend you watch Die Hard. Which is not a fucking Christmas movie. Like, please stop. I can't with these people. Kasumi Baby said, what's up, girl? What up, shorty? How you doing, Kasumi Baby? Shout out to Kasumi Baby, guys. If you can give a shout out real quick to Kasumi Baby, I would really, really, really appreciate it. Kasumi Baby is a friend and a supporter of this stream. Navinik said parkour, yeah, but Navinik, or Sally, if you could give that, thank you so much for that shout out. She is a friend and a supporter of the stream. She is here when she can. We play Fortnite together from time to time, not that often, but you know, she'd be putting her time on Overwatch, which it's a shitty game, but you know, people be playing that or whatever. So we don't judge too much. I mean, I judge a little bit, just not too much. I try not too much. Come on, go back up, bro. Or did I just stuck? I guess I just stuck. But anyway, how come they see me? Huh? I'm so confused. How come they see me? But back to what I was saying. Okay, I was already here. Oh, I guess I get to come out down here, huh? That's why I couldn't break that thing. Damn, that gave me some damage, though. Oh, okay. But anyway, Die Hard, not a Christmas movie. If you think that's a Christmas movie, I'm going to need you to kind of study what screenwriting and what a setting is and what a story is and scripting and all that stuff, because a Christmas movie entails always and or the meaning of Christmas and or Santa Claus and or Saving Christmas. Something abstruse, like, you know, like fucking gets in the way of Christmas, and somebody has to either save Santa's back, i.e. Fred Claus, i.e. Nightmare Before Christmas, or something happens during the holiday, and it emphasizes the spirit of Christmas, family, and togetherness, and like all this shit. It emphasizes that. That's a Christmas movie. When something just takes place in Christmas, you know, for example, like Home Alone, where you think, well, Home Alone takes place in Christmas, doesn't emphasize in Christmas. No, it does, because she wants to be home for her kid on Christmas. What the fuck? Where are we? Sally said, shout out to a random dude. Oh, thank you so much for that. There's more? Oh, look at that. I mean, yeah, do you trust the government, you dummy? What is this? I mean, the guy's talking and stuff, but there's another vent here to explore, and I don't know if that's the right way to go. I think I feel like I'm too exposed. Oh, this is where I came from. Interesting. But yeah, Sully, thank you for that shout out to a random dude. A random dude is also a good friend, a badass jiu-jitsu practitioner, and a guy who deadlifts every day. Like, literally, that's all he does. He just deadlifts. He wakes up, he deadlifts himself. He deadlifts his bed. He just deadlifts everything. So, yep, shout out to a random dude. He is a homie, so shout out to him, man. And shout out to everybody who's here tonight, guys. You guys are incredible. Thank you so much. You know, my ramblings can be a little bit incoherent at times, or maybe not make sense, or maybe a little bit be disagreeable or whatnot. But I just think that, you know, humankind doesn't put beauty or effort in a lot of things anymore. Before, kind of every day seemed inspiring. The fact that people were afraid the fucking sun wouldn't come up. Oh, Jibri said, happy to be here, Mikey. I appreciate that, Bri. I'm happy that you're here. You guys are really incredible. I never thought that I would have legitimate people be interested and come watch my stream, aside from, you know, just my friends who come to support me, which, you know, I'm not trying to be ungrateful. You know, you guys are awesome and I really appreciate it. But, you know, you guys are my friends, so obviously you guys are going to come support me. But the fact that I've met people online such as OG Bri and Navinix and, you know, others that I met throughout my years streaming, and that they legitimately enjoy the stream, and, you know, like to be here and chat and contribute and donate and subscribe and support, because, you know, it legit helps. Any donations or, you know, fucking you know, gifted subs or you know, biddies that you guys do, they help a shit ton. They really do. Oh no, fuck. I tell you, this guy walks on fucking ice. But yeah, no, the fact that you guys are here showing me love, it's truly incredible. I don't even know how to thank you guys, you know. The fact that you guys find me entertaining at all, it's just kind of like, what? The fact that you guys don't think my voice is obnoxious as much as I do. I feel like there's going to be some bullshit here. Oh shit, that went down fast. But yeah, I'm glad to see that you guys are happy to be here. Truly, truly grateful. really, really, truly grateful. I'm gonna save here. This game is terrifying. Oh, thank God for this handgun, huh, guys? No, we don't want to go too slow or too fast. This game's scary because you don't know what's going to be in front of you later. Oh, shit. Oh, fucking. See, I tell you, you don't know what's going to be fucking happening next. Whew, let's save. And you're also constantly saving. There's no chance for you to beat this game without you be constantly saving. So now we go back in the pipes, because, you know, our man Gordon Freeman, all he thinks about is piping down. Being part of a raw piping company, you know. Oof, terrifying. Angstil Kirlo, what's happening next? This is Angstil Kirlo from Retro Room coming to say hello. Hey, what's up? Thank you for the first time chat. Welcome. Thank you for coming to hang out. Thank you for coming here to say what's up. How are you? Welcome to the Mikey stream, the Mike Perchik late night show. Whoa, and a follow. Thank you so much. I'm telling you guys, the Retro Room is the best community to be in Discord. If you're not part of this community, you truly are missing out. There's truly amazing, wonderful people. But, and I'm sorry if I'm butchering your name, but Anseal, I believe, Anseal or Kirito. Yeah, I misspelled it. I just joined today. Oh, well, welcome. Welcome to the realm. Welcome. I hope you've been finding it to your liking. And Seal, yes, okay, and Seal Kirito, okay, thank you, man, or lady, or, you know, unspecified, thank you for the follow, and thank you for hanging out. I'm glad you joined the Retro Room. I'm hoping you're finding it to your liking, and I'm hoping you're having fun with it and meeting some interesting people. How are you? Thank you for coming by. Big bearded teddy bear, yeah, that's, are you talking about me or yourself? I am having a blast. That's great. That's awesome. That's awesome. Are you talking to some retro games, some retro technology? What are you, what is, what's your, that's you. Okay, great. Yeah, I feel that. Oh, shit, I keep falling. That's you. Okay, man. What's your favorite, what's your favorite console? What's your favorite, retro game. I play anything and everything RPG. Okay, so I reckon you're a Final Fantasy buff. A lot of people here like Final Fantasy. I know my boy, a random dude, likes Final Fantasy a lot. But that's crazy that you just joined today. I'm glad you found the stream and you got curious enough to be like, oh, who the fuck's streaming here on this server? Let me go check him out. You can't get me, boy. I started with Final Fantasy on NES, found Legend of Zelda as well, the rest is history. Oh yeah, both classics. I mean, I've never been too much of turn-based RPGs. I've been kind of impatient, but Legend of Zelda was definitely my jam, especially Ocarina of Time on N64. And I never got to play Twilight Princess. That was one of the I really wanted to play a long time ago, was Twilight Princess, and never got a chance. But I got Breath of the Wild. I try to play some of that from time to time. So if you ever want to come watch some of that, I'll definitely be streaming some of it. Twilight Princess is well worth a play. Yeah, I mean, I'm telling you, like, I don't know why they don't put that game on. I don't know why they don't have like a GameCube emulator on the Nintendo Switch. They have a Nintendo 64, NES, NES, and everything. So I don't know why they don't have GameCube and or Wii, and you know, because that's one Zelda game that would be awesome. And Seal Kirito said, thanks for the shout out, Navinix. Yes, Navinix is one of our mods, as well as Sally. We had other mods here that we haven't seen in a while, but hopefully I can mod some other people, you know, as more people start coming to the stream, depending on who's, you know, here more. I definitely would like to and need more mods. So the more people I meet that can be here more frequently, I'll definitely appreciate, you know, and mod and or VIP, depending on how invested you are. Have you heard of Setsuna? It is a classic. I have not. Sally said, Navi fell asleep in X. No way. Wake her up in X. She's having a little nap in X. Aw. Is she on the bean big? On the bean big? That's funny. Are you watching her on camera? Guys, if you don't know, Sally and Navinix are an item. They are a couple. And they are the what's it called? You know when, like, celebrities get together? What would be, like, Sellynix? Navili? Yeah, she stayed up till 3:30 a.m. their time. Damn, what was she? Was she fucking partying? Was she with the hurricane? And Seal Kirito, relationship goes, man, for real, that's crazy. Like, they're on two different sides of the world, and, you know, they love each other. So, you know, we'll say F. 9:42 p.m. here in Canada. Oh, you're from Canada. That's awesome. Welcome in. Yeah, it's about 12:42 here in Amerique, the U.S. of A, southeastern coast. We're here chilling, though. Sally said, hurricane threatened me several times, so now we have to fight, and I'm stealing Lou. Lou is my guy. I reckon Lou is a kit. Okay. On to the next part here of the game. Ah, of course. Yeah, he's my guy. You really have to be a quick gunman with these motherfuckers. Oh, God. I remember this boss. Hey, what's up? Destroy the damn thing before it grows any larger. Okay, my guy's having a rough time there. We gotta start using the shotgun a little bit more. I hear some guy defending the trenches. She said, lose my guy. Yeah, well, maybe when you get to Australia, you can take some pics with Lou for us and we get to meet him too. And Seal said, I almost moved to Australia. Oh, well, what changed your mind? COVID and not being allowed to leave Canada. Yeah, I heard Canada was pretty hardcore about the restrictions there. So, a lot of people. I could now, but sorry. I could now, but I'm set in my work now. Oh well, what do you do? Go. Woo! Okay, save there. Jesus. What do you do for work? Do you love what you do for work, or is it just a good paying job? Because either way, management, I own my own store. Oh, nice. What kind of store? Is it like a corner store? Is it like an electronics store? Is it a gaming store? A retro store? That would be cool. Oh, shite. And, yep. Gas station, Petro Canada. Oh, it's a Petro. That's pretty cool. Gas stations make good money. Do you own it or do you just like... wait, you said a management. I own my own store. You run it, but do you own it? I hate that this uses the same bullets as a handgun. Because now I'm running out of bullets for the AR and the handgun. Shut up. You too. Come on. Fuck me. And Seal said, my best friend chased it, so I run it for them. Oh, nice, nice, nice. So I'm reckoning that's still a pretty good, pretty penny, right? A pretty peeny. And he was chowing down. Can I allow that? That's always a beat. But yeah, I mean, you don't want to live a steady job. And Seal said over 20, under 30. Haha, so good range. Yeah, I mean, fuck, man. I mean, you don't want to fucking, you don't want to mess with a good check. You know, I would never advise anyone to mess with a steady, good check coming in. You know, I would never advise someone be like, yo, man. I mean, look, follow your dreams. I'm a big believer in following your dreams and, you know, taking a leap, taking a chance, doing something scary, right? I'm a huge believer in that, sure. But then again, if you're feeling secure, if you have a roof over your head, you know, food in your stomach, like good shit happening, there's no need to put that in, you know, in risk at all. No need at all. So, you know, Australia's cool and all, but if shit's going good in Canada, why the fuck not? And I mean, look, I watched Letterkenny. Canada's pretty cool. I mean, in some aspects, right? Oh, this is scary. Who here has watched Letterkenny? What do I do now? Am I supposed to jump? Jesus. So they said wearing a Letterkenny t-shirt. Jump and follow your dreams. Well, you know, like take a leap. I mean, I need to start it up because I guess you're not doing it, you piece of shit. Which Letterkenny shirt are you wearing, Sully? Are you wearing your Wheel Snipe Sully shirt? All my current ones are based around streaming, so working on it. All your dreams? Oh, well, do you stream Unseal? Because if you do, I will, as soon as I'm done with my stream, I will give you a follow back. And whenever you are live, I will try to come and support your stream because that's what we do at the Retro Realm. We support our streamers. It's about helping each other grow. If we don't come watch each other, there's no chance of other people coming down and checking out what we do, right? So, yeah, I will definitely come check out your stream. What do you stream, my guy? He said, I do stream, returning streamer. Yeah, I'm doing the same thing. I've been on and off for the last 2 years. I've been coming and going personally. I don't know what this is really about. Do I even need to get on that? I platinum trophy hunt, so lately some RPGs. Nice. Working on platinum number 30. Nice, nice. Well, hopefully everything works well and you're able to do all your dreams as far as what the fuck just happened. They're dead. Yo, Unseal, I really appreciate that you came by, you know, out of the blue, just, you know, from the Retro Realm. It really actually means a lot. So, you know, the fact that you're here right now, I'll definitely come support your stream because, you know, we have the same dream here, you know. Because you don't want to be caught on those tubes. What the fuck happened? How the fuck did I die? And Seal said, yeah, I saw you went live. And I was like, hell yeah, I've been chatting to some cool people. Now I can watch a live. Yeah, man, we have a lot of cool people going live too. Not just me. I'm just co-owner. So, you know, Navi and I have known each other for a while and supported each other's streaming and kind of coming up for the last few years. So, you know, we're always here most of the time. There hasn't been too many streamers lately in the realm, but we're trying to help, you know, push it to that direction to where we're, you know, encouraging people to stream and check out streamers and this and what. So how did that kill me before? Well, I stream almost every day so I can help boost number of streamers. Yeah, I try to stream every day too. It's a little tough though, would work, but yeah, man. What time do you usually stream? I just said it was like 9 over there, so I reckon you're like Pacific time in Canada. So let me know what times you go live and I'll definitely try to, you know, catch you while I'm working or if I'm, you know, available, I try to hop in and give love to all of the people here. There are streamers in the retro realm. What do you think though? I mean in Canada, how do you see people react to things? I mean, do you think people are being a little nihilistic nowadays? They're having a little hard time believing in life? Wow. Of course I'm gonna take fall damage from that. That sucks. Oh, but look at that. I was watching this Channel 5, it's his YouTube channel that started us all. Gas No Breaks is with Andrew Callahan. That guy went to Toronto and I was watching some of his videos from Toronto and the Calgary Stampede, which I didn't understand what it was. I usually go live between 6 and 7, so 3-4 hours ago. Okay, so 6 and 7, that's about 9. 10 p.m. my time, which I should be able to make it. Shouldn't be too tough to be able to help support a Canadian creator, one of our fellow brethren in the north. But I have noticed people are freaking out a lot easier. Yeah, in what sense? I mean, I understand kind of what you mean because people are definitely more. That is the latest I will go live sometimes earlier. Okay. But what do you mean about people freaking out? Do you mind elaborating on that? Would you mind sharing your thoughts on that with us? They're stockpiling food, drink cigarettes. True. I mean, I don't know if people have been seeing all the latest news about all these, like, billionaires building all these bunkers and, you know, getting ready for some shit. Ah, shit. Should have waited for that to blow up. Woo! Let's try again. I got 6 grenades. Let's hope this works out. As it says, they're more on edge preparing for some sort of reset of some kind. I mean, I'm not gonna lie and say that me personally, I haven't been feeling some weird fuck energy in the air, or, you know, because things want to feel good, I guess. the world wants to heal, life wants to, you know, because why is it that our memories of, you know, 2020 can't be as pleasant as our memories of 1990, 1980 or whatever? You know, even though bad things were going on in those certain times as well, a lot of people seem to look back to in nostalgia to those times because things also were a little simpler. Even because if you think about it, in the 80s, there were serial killers just everywhere. Am I wrong? There were. Oh, they killed my guy. Oh no. Yeah, exactly. So it's like, you know, we look at things with rose-colored glasses and we think, "Oh yeah, things were great." Oh shit. Fuck. And, you know, we ignore things that went on now that maybe necessarily didn't make all those things too great, you know? So now we think back about, oh, the 80s, oh, the 90s. And, I mean, maybe the music was better before, not gonna lie. Maybe the music was a little bit more fire. And Seal said, "I am just happy I have a farm, self-sufficient. My grandparents have 30 acres. Yo, shout out. Wait, what? What? Where do I get the oxygen and the fuel and stuff? No, don't tell me, don't tell me, don't tell me, don't tell me, don't tell me. Don't tell me I have to go. Ah, fuck. Fuck! Yo, but having a farm, that's what's up. Are you like the... I don't know if you've ever seen Letterkenny. I don't want to be stereotypical. But it's like, are you like the guy from Letterkenny? Are you like, standing by the produce stands the other day? And then some guys come and they're like, "Hey, bro." And see, the thing, I used to think that top tier... This used to be top tier of all games. Dude, this is top tier of all games. What are you talking about? This game is a first-person shooter, a platformer, and a horror game. It's three categories and one. Three genre... Oh, fuck. Alright. Three genres in one. What do you expect, my guy? Oh, fuck. Fuck, 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 fuck. The cool thing about playing this game is that I get a lot of fail compilations out of this. Fuck! Letterkenny wishes it could be as cool as and steal the farmer. I mean, I reckon you're pretty cool. Are you the toughest guy in town? Are you the toughest guy in Letterkenny? Oh, fuck me. Are you the toughest guy in Alberta? I'm from Alberta, eh? They call me Hagrid at work. Oh, you're probably tall and bearded, huh? Whew. Okay, so we're here. And we need to do something here, I guess. Do you like Harry Potter? I am from Victoria because a few hours from Alberta. Oh, so I wasn't too far off. You're kind of from Alberta. Have you ever gone to the Calgary Stampede? What's that about? I'm just curious because I just learned about it recently. That's why. I'm not trying to be like a dick or nothing. I heard a lot of people gather for it, and it's kind of a, even like a tourist thing. Whew, you don't want to fall down that. Calgary and Stampede is basically people running horses, doing tricks, bull riding, and fair. So it's just like a rodeo. I didn't understand what it really was because the video I saw that talked about it mostly interviewed the people outside, being like, "Whoa, I don't give a fuck about nothing." Yeah, exactly, a big rodeo. Yeah, okay. So, I mean, I don't fuck. I don't ever even. But I'm from America, and I haven't even been to a rodeo around here either. So it's just like. So it's like I don't really know like the culture, I guess. Like, I don't really know that culture, but, you know, can we go through? Huh? Oh, no! I just shook. Oh, Jesus. This is terrifying, all right. It's terrifying to do with 22 health. I am 6 foot, 408 pounds, I have a beard, and I used to have long hair. But I donated it. Yeah, I used to. I be donating my hair too every time I cut it. I have long hair, but you can't really tell right now because I have my hoodie on. I say a big old teddy bear. Well, I mean, teddy bears are cuddly, man. They're appreciated. Oh shit! Oh shit! Oh shit! Damn! I'm surprised I made it. So this is another thing we turned on now. Give the best cuddles and I am a permanent heater, bro. I bet you're a darling to the ladies in the winter, huh? They're probably like, oh, and Seal, could you give me some cuddles? I post selfies in Discord, so I'll check them out later, G. I don't really be posting selfies in Discord. I used to when I was like lifting a lot of weights and being in good shape, but I'm a little chunky, so I'm a little self-conscious, but I'll get back to it. Oh, I hear more shit. I don't care, I'm 37, fat and working. Don't like it, don't look low. Yeah, I mean, I'm not too insecure because my life, I've always gone up and down in my weight, I guess. It's just, I train martial arts and I like to be, what's it called? Agile enough in it, I guess. I don't know. Durant enough, because there are benefits to why can't I go in there? I hear noises and I don't like it. The alien is coming for you just like the aliens in Alien Isolation. I don't know where I'm supposed to go. I know I'm supposed to do. Oh, I remember now. Oopsie daisy. This game is so creative because it's also puzzly, you know? It's almost Zelda like. Thank you. Oh, yes, that's it. I mean, did I jump? Oh, I guess I do. Well, I'll be damned. Oh, shit. Down, Bessie. Oh, let's hear the fuck out of me. All right, we're going to F6. Oh, I didn't think I would have to go up there. All right. Oops. Oopsie daisy. Oopsie daisy. Fuck you. They're watching you. Don't stop. Stop, you're scaring me. Stop it. Waiting. They're watching you. Waiting. Whew. I hope I get some health soon. Like, please, Lord, I hope I get some health soon. Ah, and I hear another asshole already. Oh, these are head crab zombies. Now, see, if you were a vampire, you could just stream them. But wouldn't that infect me also? Oh, shit. Where'd it go? Whew. Okay. Alright. Ah. This game is punishing. But if you're a vampire, would the infection matter? I don't know. Because I guess vampires are technically undead. They're not like zombies, but they're not alive either. So would you be affected by human diseases? That's a very good question. That's a very good debate to have one day on stream. Dude, we gotta run, 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 we gotta run. We gotta fucking run. Oh, that didn't give me damage. Okay. I still say you should probably get some health, huh? Yeah, well, whenever the game decides to provide it for me. What do you mean there's still no oxygen? I did both the things. I did the fuel and the oxygen. Are you kidding me? Do I have to go back? I don't have grenades, Lord. No, I didn't mean to save. Ah, Lord. Jesus. Fucking die. Making me waste my bullets. Oh, I forgot to press this. I only pressed one. Wow, Mike. Way to go. Now we should be good. See, this is why you constantly gotta be saving in this game. Because if you don't, any little fucking mistake is gonna make you fuck up, and then you gotta go back and fix it. See, it was you. Yeah, I never said it wasn't me. I fucked up. Human error. You know, we out here. We're fucking up. I mean, it happens. Okay. So you're a human. Are you? Who? I never claimed not to be. I'm the most human ever, man. Because I fuck up tons. You never claimed to be either. I mean, I never knew I needed to claim my humanity, man. So the debate was still going. I mean, if you thought I don't look human because of my hoodie, I do look like a little bit of an alien. Oh, do we get to watch some fucking... Watch this. Burn! Oh. That's beautiful. Mother Nature just pissed her pantsuit! Nice. Now we got rid of that. Rip the creature. Yeah, what was the creature even called, right? I'm sure the manual said something. The Half-Life manual. But now we can go down there and see what the fuck is going on. It's funny because we had to go down there anyway. But now we have to go down there and see what the fuck is going on. Hopefully we get blessed with some health. Right? Maybe the Half-Life gods will bless old Mike Perchick here with some health. So he can continue his journey. And maybe beat the game after years of not beating it since he was a kid. Ooh. Okay, this is just getting more scary by the second. It's getting darker here. Oh, there's just holes. Please don't kill me. Sounds like there's radiation around here. A seal kitty just said, "Have life, gods." He don't really want health. It's okay. He can beat the boss until HP. Dude, I wish. Oh, what is this? What is this? Oh, baby. What is this? We got the revolver. Sheesh. Damn, look at the creature. It's dead as fuck. We gotta fucking F6 every time we do anything, really. Okay, so I reckon we go down the stairs, because... Oh, the Half-Life gods have blessed us, guys! Thank you, Gordon Freeman. And Freeman, we trust. Power! Yeah, I love it. Love it. Thank you for that. Love my redeems. All right, now we got some shield. Now we got some Haleth. Now we go back up the ladder and hope for the best, I guess. TMNT MP power. TMNT. I love Ninja Turtles. Guys, would you guys be down or interested in a teenage... Oh, no! Would you guys be interested in a Teenage Mutant Ninja Tuesday where we play either Shredder's Revenge once again, maybe in hard mode now that we unlocked Casey Jones, or do we play the Cowabunga Collection where we can play Turtles in Time, the original NES Ninja Turtles, and others? What do you guys think? Would you guys be keen on some Teenage Mutant Ninja Tuesdays back again at the Mike Perchick late night show and or the afternoon show? Because I'll be streaming in the afternoon sometimes now. I'll be streaming when I'm like, oh, I got nothing to do for the rest of the day. Or I got some time right now, you know. I reckon I gotta move this. Wow. That's bullshit. Did you guys fucking hear that? Fall damage. But yeah, I'd be down to play some Turtles in time. That would be awesome. 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 TMNT. What the fuck? TMNT always good. I reckon it is. Whew. I know I saw a head crab somewhere. I just don't know where it is. Ah. Where are you, Mr.? Did I squish it? Did that motherfucker get squished by the table? Did he go, ah? Oh. Those things are dangerous. OG Brew with the Navi hype. So, OG Brew, you're still here. How you doing? What you doing, OG Brew? What you doing, Shorty? What'd you say, Stink? Thank you, Half-Life Gods, for that health. Oh, more health. Alright, nice. So let's save. Let's get back to our shotgun here. Let's save again. There's this one part where there's these like ninja soldiers that. Oh, wow. What the fuck do I do against that? I look, the G-Man's over there watching. Like, oh yeah, everything's going according to plan. Hey, don't attack me, motherfucker. You hug it and cuddle and love it. I don't know, man. That thing does not look very... Let's go. Attack it. It's your new Baymax. I never seen that movie. Sorry. But I know who the character is. And it sucks how they nerfed it in the Disney version. Jesus. Thank God for my fast reflexes, huh, guys? Oh, what the fuck? Well, clearly I'm not supposed to go this way, I guess. I guess I had to take that shot. Whoa. Damn, these things are strong. I'm getting just rid of all of them, man. I'm an exterminator. Fuck these things. I hate them. I hate headcrabs. There's some of the fucking worst. No way. We got grenades. We gotta save them. Oh, die. We're running out of ammo in all fucking areas, guys. Oh, we're back at 100 health. That's good to know. BRB, hey, man, take your time. I don't know how much longer I'm gonna keep streaming. I am getting a little tired. It's like 1 in the morning and shit, but... Oh, shit. Pfft. Do I have any grenades? No, I don't. But I have these. Haha. That went pretty hard. NGL. Ah, now I hear those assholes. Yeah, let's keep that close. I think that means that some people that I don't. Whoa. Oh shit, I'm out of ammo on that. Shit, I'm out of ammo and grenades. Oh well, save. Will they give me some ammo? Alright, let's save. Did I just get some arrows? Oh, we're about to get that bow and arrow. I hate this thing. I don't want to hear that. Nice. Got some ammunition just all around. Got some health. Got some save. We're gonna keep the shotgun out, you know. Alright, we're gonna save here. Alright. Let's pray to God everything goes well. Forgot about this bad boy. Bro, there's a shit ton of these guys. What am I gonna do? Shit. Guess we wait. I guess we wait. We just stand by these explosives and we wait. Or not. I don't know. We'll see. Or, you know, we could just go this way. Oh, look at that. Granada. This is stressful. Turn this shit off. Oh shit. I guess he's got some shield and gold today, huh? Count our blessings instead of just fucking being all like, oh. Oh, thank God. Save. I fucking hate headcrabs. Where do these assholes keep coming from? Those first aid kits, man. So the question is, where do we go from here? If we already fucked everything up. Oh, well, I guess we go to the thing. And I'm pretty sure I heard some bullshit here. Ah. Right. Fuck. You bitch. I hate those things so much. Because they're disgusting. Look at their eyes. Oh, there's more. I really hate those things. Thank God for the shotgun. If I hear another little squealing from one of those fucking dog thingies, I'm gonna lose my mind. One thing I do love about this game is how intricate the map design is. Like, they really took their time. Like, this is a huge facility. You're traveling through an actual huge facility. I actually think they made everything to be big. And Seal said Beck had to go check out White Wolf. Guess they went live as well. Oh, nice. Well, I'm glad you went to go give some love to White Wolf. They should probably certainly do deserve it if they're part of the Retro Realm. Because I'm biased. If you're part of the Retro Realm, you deserve all the love. What are you doing? Playing that by deadline on my kind of game, but oh well. I mean, you know, people just kind of play what tends to be trending sometimes. And I know Deadlight's a very popular game right now. What the fuck? Dude, look, you guys are gonna get drained and die. You fucking worms. Yeah, let me step on you. Can I break this? No, I reckon I can't. Now, can I do the thing? Oh shit. Oh my god, that's terrifying. What does this do though? It's true, it's a popular game, yeah. Oh, I hate these guys, they come out of nowhere. Yeah, to each their own, I mean. I never played it, but I heard it's a very good game, so. I'm not definitely one to knock it. Dumbass. Alright, we're gonna give this one last attempt. And guys, I'm starting to get a little here on the tired side. So if you guys don't mind, we're gonna call it probably after my last attempt at trying to survive against the army here. What the fuck? Where did they blow up? Did they throw a grenade on me or something? Let's get ready to go Tony Montana on their ass. You talk to me, you coming to me? Say hello to my little friend. Cockroaches want to get rough. Sorry. I like Tony Montana. I think he's a great cinematic character. Great character of cinema. So do we go back? I'm at a loss here. Didn't mean to fall in the. What else do you normally play? Oh, I mean, I'm a variety streamer. I play just about everything. I have retro game night where I play a lot of like NES games, like Super Mario World, Yoshi's Island, Mario Kart, NES. I also play Super Mario Sunshine, that's one of the games I like to play a lot. I play Jedi Knight Academy. I haven't played that in a while, actually, since I bought it, probably. I like to play Fortnite. I like to play... I have a shit ton of games. Tony Hawk Pro Skater. I have that on Switch. I'm mostly a Switch streamer. I play Naruto Ninja Storm because I really, really like Naruto. I think Naruto's a hell of an anime. The story is great, and it has a lot of points from Star Wars, which I think are great. But what else do I play? I play just basically anything I find interesting at the time. You know, I was playing Monster Hunter for a bit. I was playing the new Super Mario Bros. I was playing Mario Brothers 3 on NES. What else was I playing? Fuck, I'd be playing a lot. I'd be playing Advance Wars. That's a pretty good game. What is going on here? Oh, man, what else do I play? I played The Witcher. I play Skyrim. I play a lot of different stuff. I'm definitely a variety streamer. I like to do just chatting a lot of the times too. That sounds like a variety, as you say. Yeah, I mean, I just like to kind of do whatever I'm feeling at the time. And whatever, you know, from there, just kind of takes off, you dig? I'm not necessarily too on the trendy games either, but I mean, because the Switch, you know, you can't really get trendy games, but I did want to get Mortal Kombat 11 or Mortal Kombat 1, whichever one it was. I wanted to get that one. That one seemed a lot of fun. And Howard's Legacy, just because I think it would be kind of fun to see what they do on it on Switch. I'll play in Mortal Kombat. Do you have it on Switch? OG Bree said I'll play in Mortal Kombat. I mean, I don't think you have it on Switch. I did the streaming game Platinum. It's to completion of the moment to the next game. Yeah, I try to complete games myself, and I go through all these sagas. Like, I started my first stream ever was with this game right here, with Half-Life. OGB said I'll have to buy it. I'll have to buy it too. No worries. I gotta get Super Mario Wonder though, because if not, Navi's gonna be upset at me. But yeah, so what was I saying? I try to finish games. I haven't finished a game on stream yet. I was playing some Mega Man X for a while. I gotta find a copy of that for my Switch, a copy of the Mega Man X collection, because I gifted my copy to a friend for his birthday because I wanted him to play Mega Man. But yeah, you know what, guys? I think that went 30 minutes. That's not that bad. I think we're going to go ahead and start calling it, honestly, guys, because old Mikey is getting a bit tired. Tired of Nyx. Let's see who's online, and maybe we can raid out to an awesome streamer, show them our support, and if, you know, Sally said just woken X, oh no, and Seal said I completed Kingdom of Amalur and all DLC as well as Aid UN Chronicles Rise. So they said, and she's out again, lol. Yeah, let her get her rest, you know. She needs to sleep in Xyrekin. But the fact that you're over there watching over her is, you know, it's awesome. Damn, youngster Joseph's not live anymore. I was going to go stream right over to them. But guys, you know, thank you so much for coming by. Hold on, actually. I shouldn't even start signing off without even fucking quitting the game. We gotta quit it. Holy transition time, Batman. Yeah, we gotta transition to our outro, my guys. We are transitioning. Power. We are transitioning into the end of the stream. Where we say goodbye. Where I thank you, beautiful people, for coming by and spending your time with me. I won't do it. Yeah, I won't do it. Just like Beetlejuice said, I won't do two shows tonight. I might do two shows a day, but not two shows a night. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for everybody who showed up, came to hang out with me and played some, you know, have life, talk some shit, got into my deep meaning talk of life and how I think people have lost their appreciation of the everyday beauty of everyday life and the simplicity of just looking at a tree and seeing how beautiful that shit is. But anyway, OGB said, do it, do it. I don't know what I'm doing. I do a lot of things. I think to do whatever I want. Sally with the Mikey Love. Did you redeem it? Yep. What's beef? Beef is when you need to get to go to sleep. Beef is when your mom's saying safe up in the street. Beef is when I see you. Guaranteed to be an ICU. But yeah, guys, thank you so much for coming by. You guys are truly incredible. You guys could literally be anywhere else in the world, and you guys choose to be right here with me right now, living it and loving it. And honestly, I cannot be more appreciative of you guys, more thankful, more, you know, giving as much as I wish I could give more, you know, better content or whatever. I'm doing what I can here to make sure you guys are fulfilled on your Mikey stream. So guys, with that being said, thank you so much again for showing up, and I hope you guys stay happy. I hope you guys stay safe, and I hope you guys stay golden. Good night. I just wanna be the